Good morning.
Good morning. Yep, she decided not to move.
Me? Oh, yeah. Oh, I'm back. I forgot.
She's done. She's done. It's over.
Yeah. I went to our gym yesterday to work out. I was like, yeah, we decided to come back. Yeah. We just miss everyone too much.
Yeah, we're back. That was short. Short but sweet. 1 week. I knew you'd last 5 days.
Just about 1 week. And then we packed everything back up and we came back.
Big U-Haul came last night. They're back.
We're back.
Not really.
It's a joke.
We're joking. No. We love it.
Although I wouldn't hate to be back, but we are enjoying our time in Vermont. So
I would hate for you to be back because it's so fun.
It's so fun.
Yeah. I mean, I love having you back. Mm. And you know what? Honestly, 4 hours is nothing in the big picture.
It's because we've done it so frequently.
That it's old right now, and I agree.
4 hours feels like 4 days.
Yeah. I'm coming this week.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I can't wait.
Maybe, I don't know. We'll talk about it. We'll decide. But I saw yesterday Peter Quinn, who lives He's home. He's leaving again.
Oh.
Good friend of, his mom's a good friend of mine. And then the boys are all friends. Well, and you guys too. You all know everyone. But anyways, I thought, that's hard. He's in L.A. That's hard. 4 hours. I have no right to complain.
That's so true. That is so true.
And honestly, I don't complain. Like, it's 4 hours.
Well, and it's a good, you'll have a built-in vacation whenever you want it.
That is the piece. Like, thinking about coming up is like, oh my gosh, it's heaven.
So exciting.
It's heaven. So yeah, here we are.
Yep.
She's back.
Welcome. Oh my God, I don't even know what episode we're on. 24? Has to be 24.
I don't know.
Welcome to episode 24 of the LegacyKnitz podcast.
24.
My name is Chelsea.
I have no idea. Sue.
Daughter.
Mother.
So, for any newcomers, thank you for tuning in and giving us a try. For any comerbackers, thank you for coming back. We're so glad to spend some time with you. For anybody that's been watching the podcast, you know that I just moved to Vermont almost a week ago.
Yesterday.
Yep.
Yesterday.
Justin, who is my husband, is going away for 2 weeks to California.
He's had it with her. He's going to California.
I'm moving back. He's done.
He's done. It's over.
People are going to hear that one snippet and be like, oh my God.
Oh my God, what
happened? Did you hear about all the drama with the LegacyKnitz girls? That's not true either. We're being sarcastic this morning. So I had to come down to pick up my car so I could drive it back up. So I said, what better reason?
You have to tell him why he's in California though. It's not because, I decided to go away.
It wasn't a vacation. He's in the military, so.
It's a long time.
Last night, we had a farewell dinner. We went to a local, small taco place in our neighboring town. And we were walking back after eating, and he was like, who do you think has it worse, you or me? I know it stinks to be you and, sitting at home and, you didn't make this choice. I did. And I was like, I have so many better and more distractions to keep myself busy. Yeah. Than you.
I think you're the one that's got it made.
It's like a little mini girls week.
Yeah.
Treat yourself week.
Well, and it's nice to have time to yourself and be able to come and go and do whatever you, not that you can't.
No, but
it's different. It's different. When dad's away, it's totally different.
Definitely.
Yeah.
But so anyway, that's why I'm back. So maybe.
I'm so sad.
Yeah. We're both really devastated about it.
We have a list of errands to do.
We've got a packed day.
We do.
Tell
us about Vermont. How is the first week been?
Oh, it's so good. It's so stressful, but it's so good. It's good. Everything is pretty much unpacked. We need, a bookshelf still. Mm. So we have those boxes of our books.
The apartment's adorable.
It's really cute.
Cannot wait to see it. I've only done FaceTime.
Yeah. Depending on when I decide to post this and edit it, I might put some video clips in.
You should. For you guys.
It's not. It's like...
It's adorable.
Well, it's so funny because I was watching Jenny and Devin's newest, The Woolen Handmade podcast.
I loved it.
And I was thinking to myself, I was like, we moved into the exact opposite. And they said this too. They're like, Burlington is so great and it's our, I guess we have to call it our big city.
Yes.
I'm with you guys. It's not tiny. A big city.
But I wouldn't even call it a city. It's a really fun town.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Just, yeah. So anyway, but as they were describing how they went into the rural area and they're renting a house and it's on a lake. It's beautiful. If you guys haven't checked out their podcast and that episode,
it's dreamy.
You feel cozy just watching it.
Yeah.
And then I was sitting there.
But it wouldn't fit you guys right now.
No, definitely not right now. But it was just funny how polar opposite. It's like we moved into the city and are living in this one-bedroom apartment, which is beautiful, but it's small. It's a one-bedroom apartment.
It's all you need right now for
you. Oh, totally.
There is the difference of being married for a little while. I'm not sure how long they've been married. But, and newly married. And the thing I love about Burlington, and the older I get, the more I crave it.
Mm-hmm.
The ability to walk.
We haven't touched our car.
Yeah, you don't need your car. I would love to get up in the morning and walk to the grocery store. Say that. I think I would love it. Or to have the ability to just say, I'm going out to get groceries. I'll be back in a couple hours and wander in and out. And Burlington, anyone that has been there knows it is so nice.
Yeah. There's so much to do all the time.
Yeah. I mean, and it's definitely got iffy air. It's not like, oh, like Saratoga Springs, which I don't think you've ever been
there. I've never been there, no.
Saratoga Springs would be where I would live.
Oh.
If I had that choice. I mean, we all have choices, but.
If you wanted to
move. If I wanted to move, that's where I would live.
Oh.
I love Burlington, and the more we go, the more comfortable I am with it.
I thought you were going to say the more you want to move up with us.
It's such, you know what? It's so hard because I had dinner with Kim last night, a great friend of mine, and I thought, this is what would be hard to leave.
Oh,
I have, I don't have a million friends, but the friends I have are great friends.
Mm-hmm.
And Mary and Terry and I, if you guys are watching, we have a pact. We can only move. And Kim is part of that. She doesn't know it.
Oh, but she's just
there's
guilty
by
association. There's
a certain amount of space that we're allowed to leave.
What is the?
It gets smaller and smaller.
So 15 the years
miles. Yeah, and we have this unwritten agreement. Like, can't move. You
like
are
that.
Our support.
I like that.
Yeah.
I like that.
You know, so I would miss friends terribly.
Yeah, no, I don't blame you for a minute.
Terribly. However, oh my gosh, to be with you guys too.
I know.
Same time.
Maybe
like
a
to
little,
say, hey, let's walk
little,
downtown and get a bite to eat tonight.
Maybe a little lake house?
Oh. So funny. Dad and I, well, I've been saying to Dad over and over again, I think I want a house by the lake. When we sell this house, we can never afford to live on Lake Champlain.
Oh, but you could.
A shack. A postage size house.
That's all it would take.
Yeah.
You'd
I would
there.
Love to live on a lake. And I blame Jenny and Devin for that because I want the dock.
Oh my gosh.
The dock. I'm all about the dock with my Adirondack chairs.
Yep. Even have you seen, there is a post that Jenny posted. I think it was Jenny or maybe it was Devin. Where he was
spinning.
I haven't seen that one. Him knitting by the fire.
Oh, yeah.
It was just like the sun was
the
going
spinning.
Down. And
the drop spinning
oh,
on
maybe,
the dock?
Yes, I did see that.
I was
yes,
like, holy cow, my wool would be so wet. Sorry, we're still talking about Jenny and Devin because we're excited for you guys.
We are so excited for you guys.
You might see them someday.
I know. I'm going to try. I'm going to try really hard because I would love to see them.
That would be fun, even just to pop in.
And that's what I said. It's because it's early. It's 1 to 3 at Must Love Yarn.
Oh, I was thinking it was nighttime.
No, I think the Sunday one is 1 to 3 is what Jenny told me. So
you're right. You're 100% right. I remember that now.
So I said, even if I just pop in on my way home.
You should, just to say hi.
Yeah.
Yeah. So exciting.
So that's Vermont. I'm still job hunting. So I've gotten this question a lot. Oh, my computer fell asleep.
It's back.
I have not heard formally back from the job that I was interviewing for. I heard informally that they gave a verbal offer to one of the four other contenders. But that they would contact me once they heard whether it was accepted or denied, and we would go from there. I still have my fingers crossed, but at this point, I can't keep waiting.
No.
So I'm applying like a mad woman. So for anybody who's out there and has contacts in Vermont, let me know. I would love to. I think I'm a pretty.
You've had a few.
Yeah.
Good connections.
Definitely.
You're so good at that. You're so, and all of your follow up. I feel like the door isn't closed.
I don't think it is either. I don't think it is either.
I don't think it is. But like you say, you're 100% right. You can never put all your eggs in one basket.
No. And I did that like prior to moving. That was kind of my safety raft that I was holding on to for dear life. But now that I'm up there and now that I have access to be at an interview in 20 minutes if need be, I'm just kind of pumping them out. So, and I've been applying to some really exciting positions and who knows where it will lead. But so that's the update on the job. I didn't formally not get it, but I also I'm not waiting around. So,
right.
So yeah.
You'll end up where you belong.
And, oh, absolutely.
You
and
will.
I'm
do. Such a believer in that. It's like,
yep, that's what
it'll
I keep,
happen.
That's what I keep telling myself. And so
all you have to do is the footwork.
And yeah,
that's what you're doing.
Exactly. So thank you for everybody that's followed up and who's been curious and supportive. And I really appreciate all of that. So yeah.
People think I'm drinking coffee.
That's a good fake out.
Mm-hmm.
I am drinking coffee, however.
I'm not. Water.
See, in the Seattle.
I love
this
that
is,
mug.
This is Dad's mug. It was given to him as a gift.
Chip keeps using it.
I know. And wasn't it a gift from Chip?
No.
Oh, I thought it was.
Auntie Lissa, I think.
It's so cool.
Yeah.
I love it. I've
Chip
never
keeps
it.
Using it. And oh boy, I'm going to be so mad at him if he chips it.
Yeah,
just saying.
It's gorgeous.
This is from my swap partner. I will tell you, I'm enjoying this so much because I fill it with water and then I put it in the fridge and it stays cold for a long time.
Super cold. That's amazing.
It's not right now because I just filled it. When we leave.
Yeah.
I love it. I love it.
I bet if you threw a few ice cubes in
it
there.
It would work. We don't have ice cubes. Well,
get
we
on
might.
That.
I know. Our ice maker broke and...
Justin made a few trays right before we left last week.
Oh, then I think
there
they're still
some,
there.
Yeah,
I should make ice trays. Why don't I? I'm sorry, but I love this.
Treat yourself.
I love, it's really ridiculous, but I'm this way about covers of books, too.
Mm-hmm.
The feel.
Yes.
This has a really nice feel to it when you hold it.
Don't even get me started about books and the way they feel. Rough cut pages. It's game over. Rough cut pages.
Doesn't matter what the words are.
No.
No.
I go through Barnes & Noble, and I feel like this is actually a more common thing than...
I do, too.
Than we. And I go through the racks, and you can spot them, too. Like,
mm-hmm.
the really good, the ones that are going to feel so,
so
good.
Good.
And then you look at, like, then you flip it over, and if there's, like, rough cut...
Yeah.
I will
Kathy
buy,
and
yeah.
I used to always be about the feel of a book.
Yeah.
Like, feel the cover.
I will buy a million books that I have no idea what they're about and I will never read. But I need them because they're beautiful.
I am craving good books right now. Craving them. Okay. I have to acknowledge someone that I forget week after week after week.
Yes.
I have to say hello to Emily and her baby, Finn. Maureen's daughter.
Oh, my God.
Because... we keep her company when she's up with Finn in the middle of the night. And she wanted a shout out. And that was a month ago.
Emily.
I am the worst. And
well,
Finn. Really?
Romo wanted to say hi too. He heard the news.
Yeah. Though, A, your babies are
so cute.
Beyond perfect.
So cute. Yeah.
And the fact that you watch us is hysterical. I love it.
Yeah.
And so your mom told me that, and I'm so sorry it's taken this long to say hello.
Hi, Emily.
Hi, Finn. He's a baby.
I know. Hopefully he can hear
us. Adorable. Oh, my gosh.
And then maybe if we meet him someday, he'll be like, it'll be like that thing where he's like learning through osmosis who we are.
Our voices. He's going to perk up. Yeah. Gorgeous. I think someone's home.
Oh, I think that's home.
Is he home already? He can't be. He was giving blood at like 9:30. Burglar. Sorry, we've got to get going. So anyways, it's so fun having you here. We still haven't even tried the split screen. We are the worst.
I feel like we're both just so scared.
We fly by the seat of our pants. We're so bad.
We are going to do it.
I'll probably be there next week so we can podcast together again.
That's so true.
People are going to be like, they are ridiculous.
We are ridiculous.
Make them...
But it's kind of fun.
Whatever.
Without having the technical
winter's going to be totally different.
Totally
like,
different.
Winter, because by then you'll be settled in and busy. And
yep.
Summer, we'll see.
It's just going to be a surprise every week. Ooh, should we talk about our emergency snack?
Mm-hmm. Oh my God. This was full when we sat down. And it was 8:30 when we sat down.
Yeah.
And this is candy. What are they called? They're from?
Brookstone.
They're chocolate covered raspberry and something else.
Raspberry and acai or acai?
No, something else. Oh, you won't be able to tell by tasting them, but let's see. Maybe we'll be able to tell.
No, I just wanted one. They're really chewy in the middle.
Oh my God, they're so good. So anyways, this was part of an unbelievable package we got in the mail, which we will talk about.
Holy moly, yeah.
But thank you, Trish.
Mm-hmm, thank you, Trish. Delicious.
I love that people send us emergency snacks.
It's so perfect because then when our cupboards are bare, it's like, you know what? We got one.
Yeah, like Oh my gosh, that's all that's left of the bag.
Oh my god, it is.
I opened it last night. I was like, we have one more. It's okay.
Yeah, oh, we can definitely dive into that next bag.
No, you're bringing that home with you.
No.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yes, you are.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Anyways, let's talk knitting.
Let's talk knitting.
I saw you knitting. Were you knitting? No, you were on your computer at the coffee under...
Uncommon Grounds.
Uncommon Grounds, which, oh my gosh, I love the thought of sitting, like when I come up, we will go there. I don't drink coffee, but
they have fun. Do. They have fun, like root beers and stuff like that. Yeah,
we're going to knit outside. We'll take lots of pictures when I go up.
Yeah.
I hope we're the worst at that.
I'll try and be good about it. And maybe if Benny's around, he'll be a little...
Yes. We'll have pictures with Ben, too. We'll do some little videos.
Yeah.
That'd be so fun.
So fun.
He totally... I'm sorry. Then we'll get to knitting.
Yeah.
When Jordan came and we were sitting, she said, Jordan is Ben's best friend. Mm-hmm. She said, Ben so doesn't get what you guys are doing. Because we were talking about how she loves whole like social media thing. And she was like, you guys, it's unbelievable what you're doing. But it was so exciting.
Yeah.
Because she's a young girl.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, Ben's age.
Yeah.
And she was like, it just drives Ben crazy. He's like when you get all those likes on Instagram, it makes him crazy.
I believe that.
And I'm like, really? He goes, yeah. Or she said, yeah, he just doesn't get it.
Justin and I multiple times have said to him, just wait this winter when we're sitting in our living room and you come over to watch a movie and we're all knitting, you're going to want to learn. And we think that maybe his roommate James, because his roommate James is around a lot and he's so nice. He lived in the apartment that we're living in prior to us living in it. And he's very much into woodworking, so he's very much like a crafty, creative person.
He's going to be a knitter too.
He seemed very open.
You're
to
gonna
learning.
You're going to start the Burlington Knitting Revolution.
Knitting Revolution.
Burlington.
Oh, do you want to hear something else cool?
Or men's knitting. There's a lot of men knitting.
Oh yeah, I don't know.
Eric.
Oh yeah, I know. Yeah.
We're meeting Eric in Burlington.
Okay.
Let's tell him I'm going to be up there.
Okay. I think he's pretty far.
No, not that far. Okay. I was going to go to movie night. It was going to take me 12 hours, but I was going to go. I was going to pick you up on the way.
Perfect.
Really, I honestly thought about it. I considered it.
If you showed up, I would have gone.
I considered it. Like, I'm going to go. Yeah. I'm just going to get in the car. I can go. I have time.
Yeah, why not?
I didn't. I wanted to.
But Justin was sitting in Uncommon Grounds knitting on his sock as I was, like, working away on my computer applying for jobs. And some woman came in and she was like, oh, that is so cool.
Yeah.
And you could tell Justin just like, I know. Yeah. Like it was just kind of cool to see. Yeah.
Yeah.
So,
anyways, enough of that. I guess I'm going to ask you one more thing. Let's talk about Romy. How has the adjustment been for him?
Romy, he surprisingly has taken to it like a fish to water.
I love that. I'm so happy.
It's probably a combination of the fact that neither of us had jobs right now. So like we're home, I would say probably 70% of the day. We try to get out for a couple of hours just to, like, get him a little bit acclimated with being alone. But he does well. Like, even when we get home, he doesn't bark. He isn't frantic. Yeah. He just kind of, like,
closes
out.
That is the blessing in not having a job, right, for that initial.
The adjustment.
Yeah, it's been really a gift to him because he would struggle. If you dropped him and went out for 8 hours.
Well, no, we can't. And I couldn't.
No,
it would have been
really hard.
I carry so much. Anytime I leave him, I feel like we have to get back home. We have to get back.
Yeah, well,
I probably am the reason for his separation anxiety.
No.
Maybe he's passed
You just on. Have to leave. You don't even say goodbye.
Yeah.
All right, let's talk knitting because we are 30 minutes into it.
Well, a lot of that was pre, too.
Yeah. Oh, you're right.
So it's really only 10.
Oh, that makes me feel so really much better. 10. I'm like, holy cow, we're already at 30.
Yeah, no.
We're
going
to zzz some of it.
But yeah, we take him on long walks. Yes. There's a bike path, right? So if you do come up and you bring your bike, it's like...
But you don't have a bike.
We're trying to address that situation.
Yeah.
But anyway.
You should take mine. I don't even use it.
You will.
Yet I love it.
Yeah. Don't.
Shouldn't I use it, though?
Absolutely.
It's a flat tire. Dad has not fixed that flat tire.
I blame Dad for you not being able to
use it. I blame him for not being able to. Yeah. So another thing I want to address, because I think it's very pertinent to this podcast... What has it been like? Because you've moved several times. Listen to me. I'm like, the spiritual director in me is coming out. What has it been like this time, the move being a knitter.
Hmm.
As opposed to, like, the stress of the move. Has it been different because you are a knitter?
I think so. I think so.
I would, just seeing you, I didn't see you on the other end.
Mm-hmm.
But I saw you here on both ends.
Mm-hmm. It did feel a little bit different. It felt actually a lot bit different. Because I feel like for me, like, I am not, you've seen me at my worst when I'm moving into Middletown. Like, I don't handle the stress well. And typically in life, I handle stress very well, I think, for me.
It was very understandable, though. That was out of character because you were doing the move alone.
Definitely.
Because Justin had been away.
Yeah. But I found this time, like, you know how you always encounter things that you did not calculate for, or like you get up there and like, this isn't working, or this wasn't the way you were anticipating it going. And I found Justin was much more on edge. And I think it was because he was leaving for 2 weeks.
There's so much to that. Yes.
Definitely.
Yes.
But for me, I just kept saying, it is what it is. We just have to deal with it and keep going. Mm-hmm. We can't change anything. And I don't know if that's knitting related, if it's because I get all of my stress out in knitting. Because wait till you see my garter goodness. Oh my God, it's grown like crazy.
I feel like it's funny because I've been really kind of rethinking about like you're moving in here and what the experience was like. Because it's something I would have never, I've always said never, 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 never. Mm-hmm. And for some reason, it just came out of our mouths, Dad and I. And we talked about it and it was a very good decision. I thought, all the way around.
Yeah.
But having experienced you turning into a knitter while living here, there definitely, I feel, is a shift for you as far as, I'm going to use the word anxiety loosely.
Yeah.
But even your, you definitely had struggles, like highs and lows. And I felt those had evened out with knitting.
Mm-hmm.
Which is interesting.
Yeah, that's very
true. Because I think
true.
Knitting is such a... It's so much more than knitting. I think that's it. It's so much more than knitting.
Absolutely. Well, and there's even been studies done that say that.
Yeah.
And that is so true. I hadn't even... Because
you
had totally forgotten about that.
Yeah, you used to call me and I could tell you'd be like, I'm just so blah. Just, you know, nothing heavy duty. And we lived closely together for a year and a half and I didn't...
Yeah.
I mean, normal. Everyone hits highs and lows, but I felt there was a shift.
That is so true.
I think it's so interesting. I thought it would be, like, cool to talk about.
That is so interesting. Mm. Yeah, because I think all, I'll say women, just because I think our hormones change more frequently than men's do.
Mm-hmm.
But I know, I mean, ladies, we all have those, that time of the month where it's, but for me, that was always, like, a devastatingly low.
Yes, I remember that about you. You just calling like, ugh, whatever, and hated your, you know, just very, I wouldn't say negative, because you would, okay, not to, like, I didn't feel like, oh, she's so negative. I felt like, oh, you're really struggling.
Yeah, for sure.
I didn't feel like a negative sense, but I didn't, in the year and a half, I witnessed so little of that.
True.
So I think that's interesting, and I think knitting serves such an amazing purpose.
Absolutely.
And can really be magical. Let's just say it's magical.
Magical knitting. Powers of magical knitting.
And I know for me, like I was thinking of you in the move, like to think, okay, I got through the day. Now I get to sit with my knitting.
Yes.
That.
Well, and that is almost to the best part of the 4-hour drive. And I couldn't even knit on the 4-hour drive up because I was driving one of our cars. But even just having that, like, it was just me in the car.
Yeah.
For 4 hours. And yeah, definitely exercises your mind in a way that you don't realize as you're knitting.
Yeah, I love it.
Yeah, that's a really good point.
Yeah.
I hadn't thought about that at all.
I just feel like I didn't see you super stressed with the move. I saw you have antsy moments, which, oh my gosh, who wouldn't?
Well, not to mention, Justin and I packed ourselves alone and we unpacked ourselves alone with the exception of two pieces of furniture.
And you did it beautifully. Because I intentionally sat back.
Oh, which is, yeah.
Because it is that married, you know, like, even though you're living here, you're still a married couple and you do it together. And obviously we would help whenever needed.
Yeah.
But even watching the packing and you did it beautifully. And I didn't feel the stress. And I didn't feel, I mean, normal. Yeah. It wasn't like, oh, isn't this so fun? No. Don't get me wrong. It wasn't like that, but it was
still a move.
It was a healthy amount of stress. So anyways, enough of that, but I do think it's different when you add knitting into the piece.
For sure.
It changes.
Definitely.
Boy, that's enough.
That's such a good conversation to have, though, because I feel like it's one of those underlying things that, as I mean, at least for me, like as a knitter, I don't think about it.
No.
But then when you rewind and you consider it, it's...
Well, and I think this community understands it more than the, I'll say muggles.
Yes.
You know, like, it's not just knitting.
No.
It's not just knitting. Mm-hmm. For me, it is never, I'm just going to go knit. Never.
Mm-mm.
Never, never, never. It is really my...
Like, I need to go.
Yeah, it's not a choice. It's not a choice. Mm-hmm. And sometimes it's stitching and sometimes it's spinning. Knitting for me is the most mindless, depending on what I'm working.
Yeah.
Having said that, let's get into knitting.
Let's talk about knitting. Our magical knitting powers. Okay, what do you want? What do we want to do?
I don't know.
I have two semi-FOs.
I have two hoes.
Two hoes.
And then I have three starts. I'm calling them starts, like in stitching.
I was going to say,
haven't stitched
the crossover.
At all. I'm dying to, but I have several things that need to get done, so I'm trying not to touch my stitching.
Hold off a little bit.
Oh, that.
Let's
I'm so glad
this.
I get to see it in person.
Because it's...
You might want to weave those in.
I still have some ends that I haven't woven in, and it was so funny because right after I tacked it together...
I love this.
I just put it on, and not thinking... And then halfway through, as I was sitting there on the sidewalk working on my... I was like, Justin, do I have tails coming out the back of my shawl? And he was like... No, you're good. So they stay tucked in, which is the reason that I haven't sewn them in yet, but I do have a few.
I love this idea, and I think there's others that are going to join you. You're all about the tacking right now.
I don't know why.
I
think
it's
because I'm so lazy when it comes to managing keeping something on my body. So.
I agree with you.
So I lovingly call this the dude. However, I wish I had looked to see what it was, but somebody said, it's a dudette. Come on. Like,
dudette.
Like, hello.
Oh my gosh. It is... So perfect.
I love it.
Okay, so show them how you...
I tacked it.
Yeah. People are going to want to do this.
I actually took a page out of the Cross Stitching Revolution, and I basically, I took a piece of yarn, so let me show it before I explain it. So this is what the back looks like.
So it was open. This
was open.
An open seam.
Yep. So let me...
Your colors are to die for.
I do love them. So now you can see this is where... This is
so you
inside
just took the
out.
Two ends and... Stuck them together.
Yep, and I just made it so that it was a gradual, so it looked.
So after you, this is clue one and this is clue two.
Yep.
And you stopped.
And I stopped.
And it's, oh my gosh, I love it.
And I love it. So the only little funky thing is this little arch back here, but it actually, it kind of works because it sits on my knit. Like
I don't think so at all.
I don't know. It sits well. So this is what the back looks like.
People are going to do this.
I mean, I hope they
I
do,
it.
And I hope Stephen West isn't offended.
Oh,
I posted
no.
it, and I tagged him, and Stephen, I love you so much, but I didn't have it in me to finish it. But I'm knitting, like, four other of your patterns, so I love them, but...
I think he would be thrilled. He's an artist. He gets
he
it.
Is. And let's be honest, it's called the Doodler. This is... I just
doodled
a little
bit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I don't know if you can see this, because we're almost... But you can kind of see the stitches right there.
Perfect.
The turquoise ones. And I basically took... Let me find a little skein of yarn here. Oh, man. I went to sleep again. So I... Oh, boy. This is what happens.
What is that yarn?
It's a mini skein that I had.
Oh, yeah. I know that one. I love it.
Completely. Oh, my God. Okay. So, guys, this is what happens when you leave mini skeins just wandering around your bag. Okay. So, I took a piece of yarn. I folded it in half.
Oh.
So just like cross-stitching.
Yeah.
And I threaded my darning needle.
And you looped it.
And I looped it. So the first stitch, I went, it doesn't matter. You just go in one side, then you go through the loop, and you pull tight, just
so
like.
So did you do like a back stitch?
I did a cross-stitch.
Oh.
Yeah. So here, let me, oh, it's right here. you can kind of see it. And I'll try and take a picture closely.
Oh, oh my gosh. I love it. I love it.
It's really fun. And I feel like I'm going to wear it a lot more this way.
Put it on your body.
Yeah.
It's like a cowl.
So I could wear it like this.
It's stunning. You turned the doodler into a cowl.
I did. I'm finding a cowl girl versus...
You are.
I'm either a huge shawl girl or a cowl girl.
Because small shawls are hard to manage.
They're hard to, negotiate on your body.
That
so you can
makes
do that.
Me want to say, I'm doing that and I'm not finishing.
You should.
Look at it.
Or like even...
Shrug.
Yep. When I was out at Uncommon Grounds, it was really cold that day. And I hadn't brought anything with me, but I had brought this because I had just finished it. And so I wore it like this. And it keeps you surprisingly warm.
It's a shrug.
I don't know what it looks like in the back. So I'll have someone
Let
take
me see.
A Does it look bizarre?
Adorable.
Oh, okay.
No, adorable.
So it's a shrug. Or if you wanted to get really fancy with it, it could be a one-shoulder shrug.
I... love it, and it makes me say, because I'm hemmed and hawed about, do I want to pull it out? Do I not want to pull it out?
Right.
And I love, mine's back there.
Her, your color, oh my God.
It would be, again, the cream vest. It's going to be perfect.
Damn vest.
She's going to throw it out
I'm
when I'm sleeping.
No, because I have one too.
You do?
Mom,
I bought you one.
So,
I did buy you one. I was like, I'm getting Chelsea a cream vest.
Well, and
like
I love it. Like, I get it. I do love that vest.
I love my cream vest.
But you love it more than anyone.
I'm gonna have hashtag cream vest. I shouldn't bring it to people's attention. They probably wouldn't know I wear it.
No, because now you're going to be able to be spotted. Like,
everywhere I go.
Everywhere
like, there's Sue with her cream vest.
Uh-huh. Yeah, so.
Okay, I love it. I love it.
I'll try and document what I did a little bit better on the blog. I say that all the time.
I think
I never
basically
do it,
you just put the two ends together and sew them however you're most comfortable.
Absolutely. Like,
because you don't know that it's sewn that way. Like, it doesn't appear that way because it's
no,
on the inside.
It just looks like a little hash.
Yeah. You could mattress stitch it. Is that the right name? Together. Oh. Yeah. You could sew it. I love it.
Thank you. And so the
so
only thing
wearable.
I will say, definitely take it and like, pin it and make sure it can fit over your head and it drapes at a comfortable level before you just start sewing. Because I didn't go end to end.
Did you block it?
I haven't blocked it. I don't know if I'm going to.
I don't think you need to.
I don't think I need to either.
Oh, lucky.
So I don't think I'm going to block it. But
no,
so for me, I tacked it. I'd say like, so I took this much and I tacked it in. So I didn't
it.
Go end to end.
Oh, you didn't go end to end.
Nope.
I
so this
see
is the other end.
So, okay.
There's
I'm
a big mermaid
you said
tail.
That. Yes, yes, yes.
And I wasn't a huge fan of the big mermaid tail, and I actually still have to tack this.
You could tack it again. Yeah, I get it. Good thing you said that, yeah.
But so that way, it's a more cowl-like.
It's beyond perfect.
Thank you.
It really is. It makes, like, I love the doodler, but it was more the love of the knit, because I was enjoying it. I wasn't 100% sure if it was my style. That is my style.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely.
Mm-hmm. And now I have an extra skein of Madeline Tosh that I can pair for another, like...
Yeah. I love it. Yeah.
That's my first finished object.
I love it.
I guess you could call it a finished object.
Absolutely. Yeah. Okay.
No.
I have hose.
You have beautiful hose.
I'll show them both at once.
Okay.
Because...
Oh, I haven't seen that sock finished yet.
You
or yes,
haven't.
I have. Yes, I have. I think you showed me.
I'm all about, well, I say I'm all about the socks, but I'm not. I'm all about the sweater. So I don't think I should. It's really hard to remember week to week, I have to say. I try to put things
well,
aside.
You because you have your periscope, too. So you
yes.
can really show, you have no idea.
So I try to put these right over here on this table so I remember, and I'm pretty sure. So this is my Arnie and
yeah, we definitely
Carlos.
Haven't. I don't think we've seen either of those.
No. And this is the.
Official.
Unofficial Rhinebeck sock by Miss Debbie Reese. It's being released on June 15th, which is next week. I have to get her this picture. People are dying for it.
I know. I was on your Periscope and Miss Magical Molly.
Magical Molly is cringy.
She's ready.
Like, she's just like, I need it now.
Fiending.
Yeah. I love this sock. I love this sock. It's very simple. It's very intuitive.
It is. So you didn't have to look at the pattern the whole time?
Well, it's interesting. I did for a long time because I was thinking it wasn't going to be manageable. And my head was in a different place.
Yeah.
And once I started, concentrating on what I was doing and looking at, because I can read knitting very well. Yeah. It's one of my magical skills. Not really. We all have it. Let's not be funny. Once I decided that I was going to be able to, because a lot of it is a mind thing.
Right.
It's no problem. I mean, I'd have to look again because I haven't worked on the other one in a couple of weeks because I'm madly working on other things, but I love this sock.
Yeah.
I love it. So it's going to be released by Debbie S. Reese on Ravelry June 15th is last I heard. I'm pretty sure it's the same. It is the unofficial, official Rhinebeck sock, mm-hmm. according to Sue.
According to Sue,
and
yeah.
many other people, thanks to Sharon, the lovely.
The lovely.
Seashore Sharon. So, yeah,
looks
I'm
like it's
so excited about it.
Is it an eye of partridge
heel? Eye of partridge heel. Did you say Dutch heel
I think
flap?
It's a Dutch heel, yeah.
Oh, my gosh. I love it. I'd love to finish the other one, although I might be already too late, for the fancy feet.
Oh.
Cal, because this was new to me.
The Dutch heel, yeah.
The Dutch
Did you
heel.
Enjoy it?
I loved
it's
it.
It's my new favorite.
I have to try these on. I still haven't tried them on.
Yeah, that was my next question.
I have to. I think they're going to fit lovely. This pattern, too, it's called... Okay, I should tell you the real name. Oh, my
yeah.
gosh. Don't
People
touch...
are going to be searching.
Unofficial. No, it should be in parentheses, Deb. Anyways, it's called Don't Touch Those Leaves, which I did not realize this. It's a story connected, of course, with Wendy about poison ivy. So, and I can't remember the story because
so
I was
So the color
it.
That you picked is perfect.
Yeah.
I mean,
well,
leaves are green, but...
This yarn, Hedgehog Fibers, Arsenic. Oh, my gosh. I'm in heaven.
And you knit it, what, Magic Loop?
No. I did... Okay, so I talked about this. I remember talking about this. I did double points.
Oh, for the whole thing?
Yes.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Because it's all I had in the size that I wanted. I'm down to a size 1, which is a 2.25. I finally have memorized that.
I'm almost there.
I think
really.
It's that.
Yeah.
Don't quote me.
You could be right. I'm sure.
I think it is because that's what everyone says.
Yeah.
So size 1, I used double points and I said, that's the only thing I'm not happy about with this is I chose to use double points. You know what? By the time I hit down here, I was totally enjoying them.
Oh,
I was totally enjoying them. So I take that back.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I love this. I love this.
And what kind of double points did you use?
Carbons.
Carbons. I love carbon double points.
I do too. But you know what I want to try? Darn it, I'm not going to remember them. They're the really signatures. They're really
those?
Super expensive. If they're the ones I'm thinking, I don't know where you get them. I know I could get them online somewhere. I used to have friends that would collect the set because they're that expensive. You buy them a little at a time.
Really?
I think I'm going to get myself a pair of signatures to try them. Susan B. Anderson uses them.
She's like the big...
I love Susan B. Anderson. I've always loved her, but I watched her last podcast. She's doing a Christmas sock, like everything. Like so.
Right now? Like Christmas in July?
Well, kind of like she wants to next Christmas have enough socks to wear for the 2 weeks previous to Christmas.
Oh, that just warmed my heart.
I know. Susan B., I'm joining you. I'm also going to make your sheep because I love them.
I'm getting still need to see that pattern.
I'm going
to
show you. I love
them.
I had to download it. I love them. And then she was on Dan and Kay's The Bakery Bears, kind of like a split screen.
No way!
She's lovely. I don't need to tell any of you that.
She
really
just
don't.
Seems like such a cool person.
She's just so... You would adore her. Yeah, she's so lovely, down to earth. Anyways, there it is.
There she
I love
is.
It. Everyone go get it.
Super
if you're
cute.
Going to Rhinebeck, and if you're not... It's in solidarity. Wear them for the weekend.
That's what I mean. And pretend like you are.
Pretend like that's what I would do. That's what I would have done
that's what
last
I'm gonna
year.
Have to do.
Okay, so those are my two hoes. I
Gorgeous.
Love
and this
socks.
Is Arnie and Carlos.
Yes, vanilla sock.
Magic loop double point needles.
Magic loop, 64 stitches.
And this was the one you originally started on your 9-inch.
Yes. Yeah, I did the top 9-inch.
Cool.
I'm gonna go back to them. I'm gonna try. I'm trying.
I'm going to let other people explore 9-inches.
Everyone is doing it. Andy, I think, is doing a knit-along.
Laura seems to love it, too, from the Fawn and the Frog.
Yes, she does. But you know what I'm thinking? You have smaller hands than me. And Laura is probably... I envision her to be your size.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Not that I have giant hands by any means, but they hurt.
Mm.
They hurt.
I don't know.
Okay. As we're talking about Debbie, I do want to talk about this for one more time. You've all seen it. You've all loved it. Random Act of Color. The reason I want to talk about it is because it's being released on June 15th.
June 15th. Oh, same time as the official
same
unofficial.
Same time.
Love
yeah.
It.
So many people are excited about this design.
It is. Well, first, let me just say, all of the test knitters
are gorgeous.
Holy.
Oh, did you see Molly's
KT's
and how she named it after Pete's Dragon?
Yes. And it made me want to go watch Pete's
me
Dragon.
Me too, because we, how many?
Oh, that
million,
was like,
that was the movie.
That was it. I loved that
movie.
That
was the movie. If you do have, if you are buying yarn,
Anzula,
I will strongly encourage you to get Anzula.
It's
even if you have to wait to use it, because I finished this and I have enough. I may make a 3-color cashmere, cowl.
Because
I love that cowl. The only thing is, I feel like these colors are so strong and so vibrant. I'll have two.
I mean, there are so many 3-color pattern things. That...
But it's more the colors. Like, I'm going to have this.
But even, like, the 3-color cashmere cowl has, like, the little eyelet section. So it might look
different. And I'm going to mix. I don't know. It doesn't matter.
You'll have a large amount of yarn.
You'll have a large. Because I'm even thinking for gifts. It's like, I will have enough to make. I could make this again.
Yeah.
Just changing the color. So. Really, truly, if you need to buy yarn and that's what you're excited about, check them out, because
it feels,
this,
and I think all the test knitters have said that, it's an unbelievable, I've never knit with it, but just.
This is my favorite yarn I've ever knit with. I will be honest.
She's knit with a lot of yarn.
Yeah, it's my favorite yarn I've ever knit with. The drape, everything about it is just.
And there is cashmere in that base, correct? It's the squishy base? Yeah.
Squishy base. Oh, I should have said that. Yeah. So I just wanted to remind you guys, June 15th. Oh my gosh. I love when people are excited about a pattern coming out.
Gosh,
like they are really like bursting over the socks and that. So I'm so excited.
Well, Amy and Debbie are just such talented.
They
such
are.
Talented designers.
They
so.
Are. They fly. They just.
Yeah. They pump out. Both of them are like prolific.
And you know, it's interesting because as an artist, I keep hearing people say, I have a pattern in my head. I'm just dying.
Yes.
I don't have patterns in my head.
I don't either. So I sew.
That
and
is
not,
a
like,
gift.
That is a gift.
Because
absolutely.
Being an artist, I feel like, why can't,
why
don't
I don't
have
patterns,
patterns in my head? I do for other things, but for knitting, I don't. I mean,
it's awesome.
Yeah,
it's
awesome. I'm
so
hoping
cool.
Someday that happens to me. That's all. Well, can I tell you about the bag that Arnie and Carlos...
Stitched by Jessalou.
Jessalou. I love this bag.
It's the best.
I love
like
the
that
shape.
One. Yeah,
the box bag. I love it. Because I bring it everywhere with me.
And it's monkeys on the outside. Bananas on the inside. Oh.
I love it. Okay.
Okay, so I'll show you my other finished object, which I haven't... I wanted so badly to block this out last night, and I just totally forgot. We got home from dinner and running errands, and... watched a movie and then the night was gone and I just totally forgot about it.
Blocking. I hate blocking.
It's such a pain.
It's a pain.
So this is pre-blocking. So it looks very small, but it does block out very large because Mom and I made the same size. This is a Squishalicious shawl by Julia of the Happy Knitting Podcast. Can you hold down the bottom point?
And it has been released.
It has been released.
And she has a knit along.
Oh, she sent me a knit-along?
Right now, yeah.
Oh, I didn't know
join
that.
Join her. Oh, my gosh.
So this was so fun. I ended up doing 10 of the edging pattern repeats.
Mm-hmm.
And again with this, I think I'm going to do the same or a very similar thing as what I did to this.
Yes.
And
you
tack
talked
it.
About that. You're all about the tacking.
I think it's so much more manageable. So that's what it is.
That's
knitted
beautiful.
On Adiklik Turbos.
Sorry.
Oh, nope, that's okay.
I just love the texture pattern.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a simple textured pattern.
Mm-hmm.
For the life of me, if I had to tell someone how I did it, I have no clue.
Oh, I do.
It has left my brain that quickly.
Oh,
and it's simple.
And it actually, it makes me want, I hope, Julia, that you come out with another shawl pattern with this. Because
imagine
in
a cowl.
Right?
I'm seeing patterns in my head.
It's happening.
So quickly, it's a miracle.
Ask and you shall receive. So yes, it was such a fun knit to do, and I feel so bad. As Katie was saying, she felt like she let down. Remember, as she was saying that, as she was showing it. Oh, and I know, and I said that. I was like, You did not.
No.
But I kind of felt the same way. I didn't finish it before it got released. And I just think,
yeah,
I don't know why. I don't know. But
you moved.
I moved across states. But it's done. I can't wait to block it. I can't wait to get it on my body. And yeah, and I'll show you guys if I do decide to end up tacking it together, I will definitely bring it to the next episode
yeah.
and show you guys. So I'm thinking it'll be more of like a bandana.
You are all about the tacking. I love it.
Well, because then it just like...
Oh, that is gorgeous.
And you don't have to manage it.
I agree.
So...
And I think being in Vermont, you are going to be wearing your shawls all summer.
I think I'm going to have to like wear like 2 or 3 shawls at a time in the wintertime. So.
You are. But not that it's so cold there by any means,
no.
But you're right off the lake. I think at night you'll have that lake...
Mm-hmm.
Breeze.
And we're going to be walking everywhere. Like,
yeah.
That's the thing. In the wintertime, people don't stop walking places in the winter.
No.
Just because it's winter. You still walk.
Makes me want to move there.
Yeah, it's fun.
It
so,
really does.
That was my other FO. I will take pictures and maybe post a video clip of as I'm walking it and talking it.
Yeah. I wish I was so good at all. We were talking about that this morning. I wish I was so much better at documenting. Because I'm always sad that I haven't. Yet, I know when I should be, and I go, yeah, well.
That's okay.
Like, I think I'm not going to be sad that I didn't, and I am.
Yeah, every time.
Damn it. Why didn't I document that?
It's a cycle.
I mean, we got one picture of you moving, like, and it was
oh.
the morning you left. Like, why didn't I take a few pictures while you were packing the van?
I don't know.
No. Dad had to run to the top of the driveway, which we have a huge driveway. In the morning, he drove.
He drove. He didn't move.
Yeah, and that's how bad it is to
yeah.
drive.
You have to drive.
And took a picture at, what, 7 o'clock?
It was so early.
It was early. You guys, I did not think, and I was like, they're saying 7, but it's going to be 10. Oh, no, 7 o'clock.
We
boom.
Bound
oh, gone.
And determined.
Yeah, it was good.
It was very good.
Okay.
And in hindsight, we really could have gotten up at 10 because we had to sit around and wait for...
I know, but you were anxious.
Yeah, no,
there's nothing. And you know what? So fun.
Yeah, all good.
Okay, I'm all about the sweater right now. I started I started 2 sweaters this week, and I picked up the stone cutter that I have been talking about and talking about and talking about.
It's stunning. Beyond, like
you know
stunning.
What my problem is? I'm really nervous I'm going to run out of yarn. So I am bringing it with me.
Today?
No.
Oh.
When I come up to you because it's Quince and Co.,
I didn't realize. I thought it was Brooklyn Tweed.
No, it's Quince & Co.
Oh!
And somebody said to me on Periscope that Quince & Co. dye lots are very good. Like, as far as...
They've got a really good
their consistency of color is really good. So I'm bringing it with me, and I'm just buying 3 skeins.
Perfect.
3 more skeins, just so I can... I know you can all relate to this. Like, it's stressful.
Oh,
and
yeah.
I've just started, and it's... You do not want to not have enough yarn for this sweater.
There are so many. It probably eats up so
it
much yarn.
Eats yarn.
Yeah.
This is skein number...
I'm going to bring this closer to us.
This cannot be skein number 2 because that would freak me out. But look, I have a join here. This could be skein number 2.
No, it's not.
Look at the cables. Look at this, you guys.
It's
look
unbelievable.
At this. Oh, my gosh.
I can't wait to see that finished and you wearing it.
And then, of course, I'm panicked about the size. It looks gigantic, but then I always say that and I put it on and
well,
it's not. But
big sweaters are so cozy.
That's what I want.
Yeah.
I want that. So this is where my progress keeper is. I'm going to move it because I did, like, all of this, minus the ribbing, in one day.
Yeah, that's right. You FaceTimed
yeah.
me and you were like, I did. I was like,
look
what?
At it. I love it. I love this yarn. So it's Quince & Co. Lark, Gimlian's Gull, or oh, I'm sorry, I don't know. It's gray. So
Lark is their worsted?
Yes.
Okay.
I hope I'm saying that right. I'm sure it's Lark.
Whatever their worsted base is.
Well, I say that. Is it Lark? I think it's Lark. Sorry about the needles. So anyways, oh my gosh, this is Rhinebeck sweater number 1. And yes, I would like to have 3.
You will.
I
will.
I'm all about the sweater right now. I'll have at least 2 because I have 2 other ones. One other one that, oh my gosh, I love it. It's so old. I'll bring it out for next week. It is the most gorgeous pattern. Remember I lost the pattern when we were cleaning? You're like, we were throwing so much stuff out.
Oh, the pink one that you made me?
No, no, no. It's a browny, tweedy, not brown, but like a, it's gorgeous. I will bring it out next week. And hopefully, I know I have the pattern because I found it, but of course I didn't put it with it. It's somewhere. So anyways, this is not intuitive, I'm sorry to say, yet.
But how could it be?
But again, it's my brain. I mean, it's getting more and more intuitive. At least, like, I don't have to think about how many pearls to the cable. Like, it's set up in that sense.
It's just grandpa.
I don't know. Yeah, probably is. He'll come barreling in, forgetting that we're doing this. So anyways, it's getting there. It may become intuitive. The sleeves may be intuitive. There's just a lot of odd cabling going on.
Are there cables on the sleeves?
I think so. But if they're pretty standard, that's not an issue. I just need to know numbers of, like, if it's every row 8 is a cable, I can do that.
Right.
This, I love. That slanted
Me
cable.
Me too.
Because eventually all of the ribbing is going to be gone. And it's going to be all...
because it'll grow out to the
edge. Yeah, or maybe there'll be like 2 rows of ribbing.
I love that because I love how the ribbing stays consistent.
I love it.
It's
love
gorgeous.
This sweater. Love it. So, Lara, she's like, I'm trying to motivate her to keep going on hers.
Oh, nice. I was actually wondering if she had...
I want to do it together.
Partner knitting.
The minute I say that, then I became a partner fail. Like, I'm terrible. I am. You know how many
partner
knit alongs I've entered this into?
Have you really?
I'm like, this is it. I'm going to do it.
Power of positive thinking. Let's
it has taken me everything under my power not to join Stash Dash because I want to, but I'm terrible at documenting. I'm trying to just be like non-competitive about my knitting.
I'll
I'm
never
so
work.
Competitive. Okay, should I show another sweater?
Absolutely, you should.
So then, oh my gosh, this was 2 days of work. This is obsession.
Well, and this is the first time we're ever seeing this sweater on the podcast.
So day one is to the marker, and day two is the neck.
Past the marker.
And the marker is from the lovely Christina, the cozy knitter. I love this.
That's so
Progress
cute.
Keeper. So, we are like Grand Central Station right now.
There's a lot going on.
There's
in the
a lot going on. I'm
you
so
guys
sorry.
Probably know that because you can probably tell.
You know what? Every sweater I'm making, well, no, Stonecutter isn't, but the other
top down.
I am starting to see patterns for top down sweaters in my brain. Kind of, sort of, not really. Like, I would adapt this and add some cables down the sleeve.
Well, like you said. We were talking about the featherweight, which this isn't the featherweight, by the way.
It isn't the featherweight.
It's the Madewell. But it's another example of a perfect vanilla sweater where you
vanilla.
Can play with it.
Absolutely. So this is the Madewell. Oh, look at this yarn, you guys. Molly. This is proof that Molly is magical.
She is the most
Half-Blood Prince. Mm-hmm. When the package came, I thought I died and went to heaven.
I can't believe that I didn't get a picture.
I didn't send you one, did I?
No, it was just you
I
showed
was
up
so
with,
excited.
With day
with
one's
this.
Progress. And I was like...
Yeah. So why did I choose the Madewell? I've talked about this a lot on my Periscope.
And who designed it?
And Hohi Locatelli. It is such an easy pattern. There's no looking. Because even the increases are just make complete sense. So I love the featherweight. And Amy, we were laughing about this. It's made for featherweights. It's made for teeny tiny people.
Oh,
in order. In my book, for my comfort level. Now, Allie said, but I'm making it. I'm like, you know what? If you're comfortable with that, it's beautiful.
See, and I don't even know that the body portion is made for teeny tiny. Oh, maybe it
it's
is.
This.
I'm not sure.
It's this.
See, and I think it's the sleeves.
The sleeves.
The sleeves are skin tight on
yes,
me.
Yes, and I was panicked about that.
I would have been too. I don't blame you for
Yeah, I was panicked because I do not have teeny tiny arms by any means. And I'm not one about body like that.
No,
at all. But that is one part that's just like nope. That's I can't wear sleeveless. It's just I can't get away with it.
Yeah,
comfortably
right.
for myself,
right.
not for anyone else.
Right.
But and I did want. I like a more of a closure.
Yes, for sure. That
closure,
part, sure,
like
sure.
this part for me. I've never liked that mm-hmm. for me. I
sure.
just again for me. So. I went with the Madewell because it has more of a closure, although there's no buttons involved. It's the same.
It's probably just more stitches towards the center.
More of a, yeah, exactly. Like this part is growing and growing and growing and continuing to grow.
Yep.
And then the band might be wider, but might not. And then it has arm patches, which...
What's that?
Like elbow patches.
Oh, yeah.
Which I may try to find. I'm going to pick up one of these colors. I think I'm going to buy yarn and make them and make a decision whether or not I like
them.
Perfect,
because they're not big, right? They're probably just little, like, swatch
ovals.
Size.
Oh,
okay,
they're
yeah.
Ovals.
So.
And Becky of Soprano Knits, she was the one that encouraged me to go this sweater. When I was talking about, oh, I'm just not sure with the featherweight.
Yeah.
And you know, it's an investment. These sweaters are an investment because all the fingering weight yarn that I love is the hand-dyed.
Yeah,
and,
oh, yeah.
And it's, you need a lot of it. Mm-hmm. So I was so afraid, and I am about enjoying the knit, but I was also so afraid of getting it done and saying,
I don't love that
was crazy to spend that amount of money and not... You know, so I am so excited about this.
Yeah.
And once I get a few more rows, I will try it on to see how I feel about it. I do not take a gauge.
Neither do I.
But you know how many people don't? And
I know.
I'm feeling so much better about it.
I was on the
hair scale. I'm feeling like, oh, yay, I'm not the only one.
Yep.
And the last, the lemongrass I made, I can't remember the size, but I thought I made it way bigger than I needed it, and it didn't fit me that way.
The blocking was funky with that.
It was. I think that's because it was a super wash. I don't know. But anyway, so this one, I really, again, went out on a limb. I'm terrible. I don't measure. I don't do anything.
It's okay.
And I was telling Chelsea, I made an extra, extra large, which when I buy, like, this is a medium blouse or t-shirt or whatever. But I was scared to death of finishing it. And honestly, this does not look extra, extra large.
No, I actually,
by any means. I think it's going to fit me perfectly.
Absolutely.
So I'm so...
You have me excited because I'm gonna cast one.
I feel like you said, I'm going to always have one of these on my needles.
It's such a fun knit because it's mindless.
It's mindless. But even, like, I think, I was thinking of you the whole time because you make... You probably do the small. Did you do the small?
I did
the
one above. So there was extra small and a
small.
I did the small.
Oh my gosh. You know how fast I could knit a small?
I know.
So fast.
Yeah.
So fast.
Definitely.
So anyways, you guys, oh my gosh, I'm so excited. For those of you, and I know it's a very common thing with the featherweight, like they really like it, but this piece ending here, makes them go, oh, I'm not sure. The Madewell. Becky was so good. And I was like, no, I want to make a featherweight.
It's exactly,
then look,
based on what I'm looking at.
It's exactly the same.
Yeah.
And then I'd look at the Madewell and go, no, but I want to make the featherweight. And then I was like, no, that's ridiculous. So
yeah.
Madewell. Hohe Locatelli.
Yeah.
Her patterns are fantastic.
Yeah, I know.
Her patterns are fantastic. I don't need to tell any of you that.
She is another one. Prolific.
Okay. Prolific.
And what needles are you knitting that on?
Oh,
just out of
thank
curiosity.
You for asking. Oh, they're those funky ones again that I don't know. Novas, maybe?
I think they're Novas, yeah.
I really wanted to use my Haya Sharps, but they, I don't find my fours. They're on a shawl. I think they're on Lydia's shawl that I'm working on.
Oh, that makes sense. That
yeah,
makes sense.
I mean, I didn't lose them. This is what happens with me when I have interchangeables.
They just
saying.
So I have my featherweight, but I haven't done anything with it. So
let's look at it, though, because I want to see it.
I think so.
Just a quick look, because I miss it.
Okay. Well, and I also need to sit with you and figure out, remember how we did that funky, like, we picked up two more stitches?
Yes.
So I need to, like, sit with you and see if you can help me remember.
I've been thinking about yours as I've been knitting, because, of course, I'm thinking stripes, but I'm not going to put stripes in this one. The next one.
I was going to say, because Molly's yarn,
it's
I mean,
so
not that
magical.
This yarn isn't beautiful,
well,
but it needed something a little.
Look at the sleeve.
It's only the first one, though. I finished the sleeve. I've had that done.
I don't think I saw. Oh, my gosh. It is the sweetest sweater in the world.
I do love it, and I think I will live in it, and I can't wait to block it out because I'm hoping it's going to grow at least a little
bit. It will. This, and I am the... Oh, I love the pooling. I am so excited about mine, and the reason I'm, like, barreling through it, it's a summer sweater.
Oh, yeah.
It's a summer, spring, fall, like,
oh, yeah.
On a summer night.
Throw
this equals a sweatshirt.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. It's beautiful.
I do love it, and I could fly through the sleeve, but I'm nervous that I'm going to get the stitch count. count wrong? Because we did a little funky thing because the underarms.
You know what people do, and I never understood it, but boy, now I am.
What?
Every time they do a decrease or an increase, they put one of those little plastic safety pin.
So that
when you do the other one,
you know. Oh, dang.
Because I am like this. I'm working away on a sweater. I think I don't even have to mark where I left off because I'm going to pick it up. And then I start something new.
Yep.
I do it every single time.
I definitely take after you in that sense.
I love it.
For sure.
So I love it.
That's my featherweight. I'm hoping to have the next sleeve done shortly.
Because
I do really want to wear it
this summer.
So... And let me see if I can show you what I mean by how tight the sleeves are. Again, I'm hoping it'll block out, but...
But they're tight, but you can wear tight because you have little arms.
But I just don't love the look.
Oh, I think it looks terrific. Tight.
But so for anybody that's knitting the featherweight, this is how they're designed to fit.
But to me, I'm looking at... Like, if that was my arm, it would look like... So tight. It doesn't look at all tight on you.
Really?
It just looks like a sweater.
Yeah, I guess that's true. I guess that's true.
Oh, it's perfect.
But anyway, so this is my first sleeve. And I did make it, like I said, I made it a full sleeve instead of a three-quarter
sleeve.
Which I'm going to do. Definitely. So.
I think it's perfect.
I love it. I'm excited about it. I'm excited about the product, the final product.
You're going to live in that.
Can't wait.
You're going to live in it.
Can't wait. And I'm using a Vivid Yarn Studios yarn in the pear colorway and... Hedgehog fibers, skinny singles, and the copper penny colorway for anybody who hasn't watched before.
Love it.
That's curious. So I also, would you have more?
I have one more sweater.
Oh, I have my garter goodness and then two squares on my blanket.
Go for your garter goodness.
I'll go for garter goodness because then I'll start knitting on it.
Yeah.
So I still haven't switched over to a 60-inch cord, so you're not going to be able to tell how massive this thing is, but it's massive.
Oh my gosh.
I really wish I had the 60-inch cord, but you can...
Do you have a 60-inch cord? You don't have one in your Addy? I wonder if they have a 60-inch...
But it doesn't... But I have... I'm using Hiyas.
Oh, but you're not using interchangeables.
No. Darn it. So, but this is the garter goodness. It's literally knit.
This, to me, was your moving saving grace.
Oh, yeah.
This was it. When we were talking about that, I was thinking about the garter grid. Oh, my gosh. And tell them you're thinking about.
Yeah, I'm going to do mohair for the second half, I think, or a few rows in here. So I've been doing stripes.
Adding it to this yarn. You know, I think you're right about the pink.
I think pink just makes more sense.
The green is a...
It's. I mean, who knows? Maybe I'll do two rows of the pink and a row of the green. You know what I mean?
You are so adventurous, and I love that. I love it. It looks like on camera, it looks like, no, don't do that. In person, it looks good. And remember, this is kid silk haze.
Yeah.
The problem is, I don't think you're going to love working with it. That's why I think a couple rows.
Okay. That's good, though.
I don't think I would commit to a large, even if you had put it in with that. Darn it all.
No, that would have been really cool. Mm. Or even the Madeline Tosh unicorn tail down there at the bottom.
Yeah.
But,
So this might go in it.
So I might do a little mohair.
It was in the box downstairs.
Yeah, we have this Tupperware, which we have to go look at.
Yeah, we do.
So definitely I have had moments where I have yarned overed at the wrong place, and I've made little clusters of yarn overs, but you know what?
This is huge,
and no one will know. And it actually almost looks like a flower. I don't know if you can tell from there.
This is Isabel joined us. Oh, yeah.
It looks like a little flower.
No one's going to see it the way it drapes. Yeah. No one's going to see it.
No one's going to see it. So I just adjusted it, and I moved the stitch marker back.
He's growling at Isabel. Poor Izzy.
He's not being a bully. So this is what has been taking up my knitting time, and I love it.
I think it was the smartest thing to have that, because I feel like you've had no frustration with that knitting, and most knitting comes with enough frustration at points.
Sure.
And that is a...
Well, and I never got bored. When I got bored, I was like, I'm going to throw a stripe in there.
Yeah, which is amazing, that piece of it. Like, you're not bogged down by the size of it. You're just like, I'm going to go knit on it. It's a good thing.
I definitely don't complete row. Like, I'll stop mid-row sometimes now because I think I have well over 500 stitches. So it's definitely...
Okay, so I started this yesterday.
So cute.
I started this. Yes, I did. I started this. No.
Yeah, you sent me the picture yesterday.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Romo, stop it.
Romo's being a bully.
Stop.
Izzy Fizz, where are you, honey bun? Oh, poor Izzy. What do you want, honey bun?
Sorry. You're going to have to get down. Look at him. He's vicious.
If you saw the side, we
Cujo.
Used to see. Izzy, you got to go, honey bun.
Excuse
All
me,
right.
Cujo?
So, there's two baby girls that have been born in the last month that need to be kept warm this winter. So, here it is. I love this.
Gorgeous.
Again, top down. Oh my gosh, top down.
Do you prefer the top down now?
I do.
Yeah.
I do. It look at it. There's no seaming. There's no pieces.
I definitely do not blame you. I having only
Oh
look actually
at how gorgeous this is.
It's that gorgeous. Is beautiful.
I did this is a very odd size. 12 to 24 months.
Why is
I've
that
never
an odd
heard,
size?
Like
that's a whole year.
It's a good size sweater. I tend to make good size sweaters. Little sweaters are really quite wasteful. Although, if and when you have babies, you will have a whole box of little sweaters. Don't worry.
I feel like between Romo, you're going to have to get down if you keep doing that.
So fresh.
Please stop.
I don't know what Izzy thinks she's going to get here.
I'm not sure.
He sounds vicious. He's frightening. Yes. Anyways, this is a pattern. I will tell you the pattern and what I am using. And hold on. Darn it. Did I not bring it over? Anyways, it's from Valley Yarns, which is Webb's. Frida baby cardigan. Isn't it beautiful?
It's perfect.
It's perfect. So I bought this yummy grape color, and then I thought I brought the other skein over, but I must not have. Like a grayed out lavender for the other baby. This one has to be done by Monday.
You can finish it by Monday.
I think I can,
but
of
it has
course,
to be the only thing you knit on. That.
I know. I think I can. Really, truly, I'm gonna.
So
get
wait,
them.
Why is there a shower on Monday?
No, I'm gonna see Louise.
Oh,
it's for Erin. Okay. It's for my good friend's daughter who just had her second baby.
Mm-hmm.
Then I'm wishing I made something for the first baby, like
oh,
to give at the same time. No, I did at the time, but
oh.
Then I thought, no, see,
so
you're
you
crazy.
Just...
I'll buy him a coloring book.
I was. Literally took the words right out of my mouth.
Yeah, hopefully I will do that if I have time. So I'm going to get the buttons today, the double-pointed needles. I'm just using Knitter's Pride, size 4. It's a DK weight yarn, Valley Yarn DK. I'm sorry, I don't have the band. But it's 3 balls. It's a $15 sweater. Look at this sweater for $15.
It's beautiful.
So yeah, you have your choice of 4 sizes, 0 to 3. Who makes a 0 to 3? Again, I will for you. 3 to 6, 6 to 12, 12 to 24. The thing is, to go that small for a non-knitter, like you're a knitter, so you would know, like, okay, we're going to rotate these sweaters around
yes,
and make sure they get to
the
wear
time.
Them.
Yep.
But if that's not the norm. People don't think that way. So anyways, I always go a little bigger. So that is the third sweater. I did a lot this week, and on top of it all, I had a super busy week. I don't know how it happened.
I feel like, you know what I think it was? The clear minds. Like,
oh, I cannot even tell you.
Yep.
The difference
mm-hmm.
when you remove two people out of your house, two adults,
yeah.
The mind space in my head, not that I did anything.
It's totally just subconscious.
It is.
Yeah.
It is. And I, the first day,
mm-hmm.
and then the whole weekend, Jacob was gone too.
Oh, that's right.
I was like a machine. I was like on fire.
That's what I'm saying.
Because of, I'm glad you mentioned that because that is such the case, especially for my personality,
mm-hmm.
being an introvert.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, yeah.
I'm just all about playing right now. I'm sorry.
Uh-huh.
I don't like, I'm not saying that like, but I'm so grateful that I have that ability right
yeah.
now. It's
oh my
just
gosh.
So fun.
Absolutely.
And
it's
not
extra
that
space.
It's and it's headspace.
Yeah.
And it's I'm such a feng shui girl. Like
uh-huh.
a full basement pulls me down.
Me too.
Yeah.
Me
it
too.
It pulls me down.
Yep.
So now that the basement is empty, although the ping pong table went right up, the ping pong table has been through
so many years.
Ping pong table is the favorite object in this house.
It is. It's
hysterical. It's hysterical. So the ping pong table went right back up.
Yep.
But anyway, so 3 sweater starts. Well, stone cutter was started, but only the rib.
Yeah.
Okay, we got to keep moving. We got errands to do. So, in the mail this week.
Yes.
Magical Molly, that yarn came. I was panicked because I knew I was going to have to sign for it because I bought something for you at Christmas time.
Yeah.
And I knew I had to sign for it. So I said to Dad, if I'm not home and you see the mail truck come down, you run downstairs.
Yep. You don't walk.
Like, well, they'll leave it. And I'm like, no.
They won't.
If I got a notice on a day that said it was here and I missed it, I would have been like, are you kidding me?
Yeah.
So I was there. And I was like, yes. And two things came the same day, I think. So then, hold on one second. I feel like I put things here that aren't here. Anyways, it doesn't matter. The same day, my pieces for my wheel came that snapped.
Oh, I didn't see those.
Finally started spinning and the footling. I'm so sorry, I'm saying that wrong. It's a piece of rubber that connects the...
The pedals.
Yes.
We'll go with that.
Broke.
I know.
Snapped. I was like... Are you kidding me?
We got home, and Mom was sitting there with her wheel, and I was so excited, and she was like, nope, it broke.
It broke.
What?
So, thank goodness, and it's because I don't use it. Let's be honest. Aileen kind of said, Sue, if you use it, those things don't break. I'm agreeing with you, Aileen. You are right. So, I was so upset. So, I got online really fast, and I found the parts. I've said this before. I cannot believe how expensive my wheel is now.
Yeah.
I think I paid... $450 for my wheel.
Which still isn't cheap.
No, that was a lot.
Yeah.
And that was pretty close to 15 years ago, because I feel like I got it when we moved in here, because I went on a spinning retreat. And it is $750 now. I could never afford to buy a wheel now if I wanted one. I'm so sad about that.
Do you think that's indicative of the industry booming? Or do you think that's just...
I have no idea.
Costs going up? That's wild.
And it's the whole, like, I did the whole thing. Like, it's a double treadle. I got the package.
Mm-hmm. You did.
When I got mine. And at that time, it was like, holy cow, I can't believe I'm spending this money.
Yeah.
And I did it kind of feeling angsty. And then the postman, I remember, left it at the top of the driveway. I was like, my spinning wheel was at the top of the driveway in the box. I was so upset.
Within the element, or amongst the elements.
And my mailbox isn't like...
You can't even see
seeable,
the mailbox.
Seeable. So anyways, that's not awful. The point. So those pieces came. I'm hoping to start spinning this week. I've got
to
get it put together. It's together broken. Those pieces are broken. Look how yellow they are.
I was wondering.
That's why they broke. They snapped. So use your spinning wheels.
Brittle.
This is the lesson. So those came, and then Molly's package came. So I got enough of my half-blood prince to make my sweater, obviously.
Look at that.
Oh, my gosh. I think I'm going to have plenty, if not an extra, which makes me so excited.
Oh, my God. To have that in your stash.
I feel...
And to have a sweater made by?
And a sweater. And I feel so lucky to be making this sweater with this yarn. I really, really do. I don't know why.
Sure.
It's just such a treat. And the fact that I was able to get the amount that I needed, because Magical Molly's the best.
Yeah, she's just so...
I love Magical Molly.
Yeah, great.
And she sent the most delicious treats.
Yeah.
These chocolate-covered, like, sugar wafer kind of things.
Ooh.
But it's not inside. It's solid chocolate. And there's two boxes, and Chelsea doesn't get one because she's allergic to nuts. I'm so sorry.
But Molly sent me a box of my all-time favorite tea. Holy crap. I got home yesterday and I saw it sitting on the island and I was like, whose is this?
Yeah. She's so
excited.
And Mom
goes, it's yours. Molly sent it. I was like, oh my God.
Yeah. Because I'm not a tea drinker, I don't even need one. I may keep one for Graham.
Oh, for sure.
One.
Oh, she would love it.
She would love it.
She would love it. Yeah.
Yeah. But yeah. Oh my gosh. So this came and then she told us to pick out a skein of DK each because I was talking about how I hadn't used DK yarn. You got Half-Blood Prince.
I did, because I saw you ordering it for your sweater, and I was like, I need...
It's the most fantastic color. This is... Okay, I don't even care if I like it.
I need to order some of that, too. Oh, I love it.
Thank God I love it, but the title, If You're a Bird, I'm a Bird.
Do you know what movie that's from?
No.
Oh, The Notebook.
I didn't know
that. Oh, you have... That was so, like, my, like...
If You're a Bird, I'm a Bird. Now it's even more special. It makes me want to cry. But having said that... Can you stand this color? It's
okay,
perfect.
Put it up close so they can see like the specs. I need to order some.
It's
some.
Perfect.
So what are you planning on making with yours?
Okay. I am going to make, I am obsessed at the moment with shorties.
Short socks, yep.
Not Bay City Rollers, Rose City Rollers. Like, I mean, they're okay.
They're fine.
But I like a cuff.
Yep.
That's the difference for me. So, and when I say shorty, I mean a cuff, drop the heel. Like, not a cuff, a little bit of leg. A cuff, like peds. We used to call them peds.
Peds, yeah.
Do we still call them peds?
I do because you did. So I don't know if it's an all across the world thing, but I definitely
peds.
Do.
Why are they called peds? I always called them peds.
Are they called peds?
I don't know. I'm making peds. Either that, or I'm going back and forth, or a blueberry waffle shorty.
A super shorty blueberry waffle. Yeah.
Because it's 255 yards, so that's probably only enough for a shorty.
I
don't know. I love it. I can't wait to have them on my feet.
They're going to be so cozy warm.
Oh, my gosh.
And I've never made DK weight socks.
I know. The killer is we're going to want only DK socks after that.
I know.
Darn it.
What size needle? 3, typically?
I'm going to use a 3, and I'm going to do between 48 and 56 stitches. Okay. I feel like you probably would do a 48.
48.
And I think I will do a 56.
I'm thinking about doing fingerless mitts.
Oh, you are all about fingerless mitts.
I am, and do you want to know the ironic part about it is I never make them. I always plan to make them, but those ones that you made with your own loops yarn.
I think you should take them. I don't wear them.
I just melt for them.
Yeah, they're gorgeous. They're the dragon hide, I think. They're gorgeous. I feel like you should. I was looking at them the other night. They're upstairs. I feel like you should take them because you know what? I don't like fingerless mitts. I like finger mitts. I like when you do them in fingering weight and you have your fingers here.
For sure.
Because they're warmer.
Sure.
Because they close in a little more. Yep. Mm-hmm. I don't mind making them. I love making them.
They seem like such a fussy knit.
They're not. They're fun. Not? Okay. I made them. I could kill them. I made them for Ben when he was a drummer in the...
Where are they?
He lost them.
Oh, my God.
What was he in? What's that called?
Marching band.
Marching band. He was a super cool drummer.
Yeah, he was in Drumline.
Yeah, he was in Drumline, and he was amazing.
Yep.
He was so not a marching band kind of kid.
No, but...
He was like the cool marching band kid. He really was.
Yeah.
I wish he stuck with it. He should have played in college. He was so talented. So talented. Mm-hmm. But anyways, it was freezing, so I made him a really cool pair with opal grays and blacks and Fair Isle look, and they were gorgeous. I have one upstairs. One has fingers and one doesn't. So I must have made two pairs.
Two sets, yeah.
Yeah, but I love with fingers. I will make you a pair of those because you will love them.
Well, maybe if you're going to gift me that Aloops pair, then maybe I'll make them with this.
I think DK is too heavy for
too heavy.
That
Oh,
kind.
Fingering?
Fingering.
Oh,
yeah,
okay.
Fingering. I finally found the pattern again.
Ooh.
So, yeah. So, magical Molly, you're
Thank
the best.
Thank you. You're amazing.
Can you imagine meeting Molly?
No, we were talking... Molly and I were talking about that on your Periscope.
Could we meet at Rhinebeck? Let's just say it. I would love to go to Germany.
Oh, my gosh.
We could meet Julia and...
And Molly. I know.
Darn it. I hate... I don't hate. That's a strong word. It's so frustrating to me to have all these people we know. And, like, especially with Periscope, because there's interaction.
Yeah.
Like, I would die to sit in their presence and knit. Like, Tracy, I want to run over and sit with her in her garden.
I know.
Yeah. Anyways, let's keep going.
So thank
we've got
you,
errands
Magic
to run.
Molly, thank you.
I feel so lucky. And I'm not just saying that. I really do. I don't know why. To have
beautiful.
A sweater's weight amount or sweater or, amount.
Yeah.
That's not right. But yeah. Okay, then we got another package in the mail.
Yes.
Oh, my gosh. From Trish.
Who has the
Yarn Cellar
Studio.
And before I forget, there is a coupon code that Trish is offering to you. And wait till you see what it's for until July 31st. And we will put this in the down bar. And we means Chelsea.
I will do that.
And let's just pray this can go up in a reasonable amount of time without Justin being home helping.
We'll see.
I would offer, but
we have no producer present.
We have no producer. We're going to try our hardest. Anyways, LegacyKnitz 15, and Chelsea will write that at the bottom.
Yep.
15% off. She's a bag maker, mm-hmm. although she sent us way
more than a bag. Yeah.
Until July 31st. So please go look at her shop because her bags are gorgeous.
Well, and it's good because you have over a month where if it isn't in your budget right now, you want it to save.
Almost 2 months, really. A month and a half.
Almost 2 months, yeah. So keep it in mind. It's a great discount, and the bags are great. I haven't put anything in mine because I wanted to show it to you.
Well, plus we had to pick, which is the hardest, you guys.
It's always the hardest part.
We had to pick three things for her.
Three things.
So, these are the ones we picked. Oh, my gosh.
And she does have this fabric available in her shop right now. Look, the color just got so funky. Did you see that?
Yeah. I wonder. I feel like it's accurate, though. Do you?
It is, but you see how everything else got blued
out?
Yeah,
like we look
That's so weird.
We're dying.
Yeah, we're not.
We're not. We're fine. Don't worry about us. Look at this. You know why I'm so excited?
Why?
Because I was about to have to, what was I going to put my featherweight in? I was going to take something out of something because I needed a bag for my featherweight. This is the perfect size.
It is.
Perfect size. Because the featherweight, being fingering weight, doesn't need a gigantic bag.
I keep mine in a much smaller bag than this.
Well, and my stone cutter is in, I should have brought that over. I showed it on Periscope.
Connie's. Yeah.
Cannot believe that is big enough to fit my stone cutter.
It's huge.
So, my featherweight's going in here.
Yep. I don't know what I'm going to put in here yet. I need to figure that out. But, we both picked the elephant print. They have these beautiful...
We could not pick the elephant.
We're elephant people. So, this is the little zippered pole.
I think so.
Little tree.
Tree of life.
Yep, a little tree of life.
Oh my gosh.
Which is super cute. It has a removable handle that you can attach to the D-ring.
The perfect amount of interfacing.
Yep. Again, I agree. Not too much, not too little.
Not too little.
So it squares out. Yep.
It would sit, but if I had stuff in it.
Yeah. Yep, it definitely...
I love this bag.
It makes
me smile.
Look at the elephants. Everyone knows how fond... I mean, I am, and you are as well.
I am, because it's funny... I'm sure he told the story, but Jacob, since he was born, was obsessed with elephants. He has an elephant collection. Anywhere we went, he found an elephant.
Dumbo was his favorite movie.
And when we took him to the circus, I don't like that whole thing, but we took him to the circus, and to see his face, he was two and a half. It was like he saw God.
I know.
Really.
I know. It was like... Which they do say, not that.
Elephants
God, not
are very spiritual.
Incredibly spiritual.
Very
animals.
Spiritual animal and brilliant, and they're super cool. So mine is kind of, I always have a warm place in my heart for elephants because of Jacob.
Mm-hmm.
And then you love them.
Yeah, I don't know why.
Yeah.
But I do. I know why. They're just really interesting animals to me because when you read up on them,
they're so
much farther than the spiritual aspect. And
they're brilliant.
Read up on them. They're really, they're interesting animals.
And... the design factor.
Yeah, look at this fabric.
Anything elephant, there's so much you can do with them.
And it's always so vibrant So she does have, I think I already said that, but she does have both of these fabrics in her shop right now. We checked before we went. And she is on Etsy.
Honestly, I have not seen this anywhere else.
I haven't seen either of these anywhere else.
So then, she was so generous.
Yes.
And I was torn for this one.
Me too.
Because, again, I've never seen it.
And
like,
I love
Mermaid of the Lake. Is that what it's called? Why can't I? Black Lagoon.
Yeah, Mermaid of the Black
Lagoon. I never know. Sorry, Molly. We're the worst. Anyways, I think this is a soup because it's mermaids and turtles and octopi. And look at that. Yeah. Seahorses, is that?
Yep. Seahorses.
Let's open it. Oh,
seahorses on the inside.
Oh my gosh, it's so cute. So this is going to be a giveaway.
Mm-hmm. For you guys.
For you guys. Yes. So generous. I think, Trish, if you don't mind, we don't have a knit along going right now. So this is going to be for our next knit along, which I feel like once you're settled.
We're going to start something.
Yeah, we're going to start something. I don't know what. I do have a knit along going on right now. I should talk about this super quick. My Knit 24 fan group on Ravelry, which is my Periscope group, which you are all welcome to participate in, whether
it's
you can watch
so
my Periscope
fun.
Or not. because it is an amazing group of women every morning.
And men.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Yes. Jason and Eric are on it mm-hmm. quite often. There might be more. I have like 85 people every morning jumping on. And I'm not saying that because it's not about me. It's about the community that they talk amongst each other. They know each other.
It's so cool. It's like every time someone comes on, it's like, everyone's like, oh, hey, how
yeah.
are you? Oh,
yeah.
How are you?
So it's so cool. If you haven't been able to watch, and you can even watch the replay. Mm-hmm. All that being said, I have a fingering weight sweater knit along right now going on. Mm-hmm. It can be one that you have languishing in your closet that you're like, all of a sudden feel like, oh, you know what? Now that I've seen Sue and Chelsea making their, I'm on that. I'm so excited. You can use that one. You can use anything. Mm-hmm. And it's going till September 1st. I told people a while ago, I haven't started yet because my yarn didn't come, but start. And so this isn't for that. But so anyways, there is a knit along there. And then we will come up with a knit along over here of some sort.
Yeah.
Soon. And this is going to be one of the prizes. So Trish, oh my gosh, thank you so much.
Thank you, Trish.
So much.
And we haven't even talked about
the rest of the stuff.
The rest of the pack. So she gave us two big bags of these chocolates. So like Mom said, she's going to send me home with one.
She gets the other one because this is ridiculous.
I haven't stopped eating them for 15 minutes.
Last night, I ate a whole handful twice.
They're so good.
So this.
Mm-hmm.
Unbelievable.
We're both just sitting here trying to chew furiously.
Unbelievable. She sent us each a bag of minis. Again, we had to choose. This one wasn't hard because they're both perfect. And
they're both beautiful.
Well, I say that. That's what makes it hard for the bags. It was like, I don't know, you pick. I don't know, you pick.
Mm-hmm. How Hannon gorgeous.
Hand dyed.
Mm-hmm. So there's not
the Amy Lee Show.
Yeah, I'll have to reach out to you, Trish, and just see if she's a friend of yours or if it's just a local dyer. But either way, these are gorgeous, and thank you so much.
I'm dying to work on my blanket.
I knit two squares this week, and it took every bone in my body not to just keep going.
You can, though.
I can, but I'm also, like, so obsessed with this right now.
I know. I feel like I can't right now because
sweaters. Sweaters,
yeah. And especially the baby sweater right now.
Yeah, that's on, yeah.
Then, this.
As if that wasn't enough.
This was a killer to decide.
Trish. Oh my
so
God.
Amazing.
Mom sent me a picture.
I was dying.
Of this, and I was like, what is that?
Okay, so
she's
it
like,
came.
Trish sent it to us.
I know. And this, like, I did pick this one because this reminded me of
Mermaid of the Black
Mermaid.
Rainbow.
And I thought, oh, having said that, it's definitely
it's
not
stunning.
The same.
No.
But it's similar enough that I thought, you know what, I just use something similar.
Oh my, and I had no preference at all because, honestly, any hedgehog sock yarn.
That's how I feel.
Oh.
I am so excited, and I'm so excited to really, I've really started using my yarns for socks.
Yeah,
like enough
you
of
did.
This, like, no, I want to save it. Nope. Mm-hmm. Cast them all on.
Do you want to know what I'm going to do with mine?
What?
I'm going to cast on my first two-at-a-time socks with this.
Yes.
That's what I decided.
I'm going to use my sock blank for that. I think.
Yes, that's right. You said that.
I think.
Mm-hmm. So mine is the Fiesta colorway, and it is in their twist sock base, just so you know.
What do you think that is?
Fiji.
It is Fiji. Okay.
I would think so, yeah.
Okay, Fiji. I think this was a recent sock club skein. I don't know about that one, but I think this one was, and it is so beautiful.
Beyond stunning. Trish, like, holy...
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh my gosh, this package was like... So, it came, and it was wrapped beautifully. Like,
yeah,
I thought, we're going to save it, we'll open it on this. I'm just like... So then I open one thing. I'm like, well, I'll just open one thing. Open the yarn. I'm like, I'll just open the yarn so I can send Chelsea a picture. An hour went by. I'm like, I should open the bags because I'm not sure if they're all the same because she said there was one for one of you.
A giveaway, yeah.
I should open the bags.
Yeah, definitely.
An hour later. It's like, well, why not open the other one?
You know what's kind of fun, though? It's like you got a new package every hour.
Every hour. I couldn't open it all at once because I'm like, nope, I'm going to save that for when Chelsea comes. And I'm like, I'll just open it.
Well,
I'm
the thing
worst.
With me is I would always prefer you to open it because I want to see, I want to know.
But
so
it's so fun to open it. I feel
it
like
is.
I deprive you of that
no,
every
my gosh.
Single
no,
time.
No, you don't. That's, no. But anyway, Trish, holy moly, thank you. You guys go over to her Etsy store. Take advantage of the coupon code if you are able. Awesome. Awesome. Thank you so much.
Did you get the note on what the rubber stopper was?
I did.
Thank you
to everybody. I felt like such an idiot.
I just felt terrible that we weren't able to share that information.
I know.
Especially after that was one of the things that you were struggling with.
I know. So now I'm going to...
We're the worst for reviews.
I'm going to take back my one criticism of it because it seems as though they had already fixed it and I didn't know.
So you put it there.
I stuck it right in there and I'm good to go.
So let's tell them. So that rubber stopper that was up here that we're like, oh, we're not quite sure.
Do we put our needles in?
Really? Like, I really like to do reviews. We're going to get, like, fired.
Don't fire us.
Don't fire us because we love your product.
We're just...
And I've told everyone, it's under the Sue Said So now, so we're safe. But so you take that rubber stopper and you put it...
On that way.
It doesn't go anywhere. You know what, though? It makes me say, how good are they to really, really address the things...
Well, because it's definitely... Oh, God, listen to me talking like I know what I'm talking about. I do think it's a recent addition because both...
Yeah, we don't have them.
Yeah, yours didn't come with one, and then my mustache one didn't come with one. It was probably a product of that feedback.
I love
not mine, but
that they're so concerned about continuing to improve their product.
Mm-hmm.
I'm impressed.
Yeah. Well, did you hear they hit 100% of their fundraising? Are you not getting the emails?
I'm so bad at it. Again.
They pop up on my phone. That's the only reason I read them.
I feel like I didn't get that one.
But I believe, I mean.
That is so, I am
I believe they
so
hit 100% of their,
thrilled.
Their GoFundMe page. So
good
hopefully
for you.
We'll be seeing a big Sally sometime soon.
I love that they asked us to review it because it's really, because mine, I will be honest, was tucked away with a project.
Mm-hmm.
And I kind of just got lazy about it. And now it's back. It's full steam. And it's killing me because I need one for my featherweight.
That's how I feel too. I'm to the point where I need to buy a new one.
I do too.
One,
I need to buy another one, at least one, if not two.
Mm-hmm.
And because I'm working with so many fingering weight yarns right now, and honestly, even the DK weight would work in here because
mm-hmm.
they're small balls.
Mm-hmm.
I'm feeling like I'm getting spoiled, like, oh my gosh, like I want one for everything. But having said that, I will show you another thing I started this week that I forgot about. What is wrong with me?
You're a knitting
fiend.
And
look at how much I got done.
I know.
I think, you know, honestly, I'm not fast. I knit for hours.
Constantly.
I do. I knit for hours. I bring it everywhere.
Yep. I
started, oh darn, I'm so sorry. I don't know the name of the pattern. Again, I started it for the cookie jar along. It's a cookie A pattern. It is fantastic.
What is the yarn? Just go ahead and say it.
It's Hedgehog.
Hedgehog Monet.
One of my favorite colorways.
Oh my God, it's stunning.
I love it.
Stunning.
Next, I'm going to pull out my woolen vine for socks.
That's a good idea. I need to.
Because I have two skeins of woolen vine. I've never used her yarn. Kristen,
that is crazy. You have more than two skeins, don't you?
No, I have a three. Look, you can see the tags right there.
I was going to say, I definitely think we both got
it. I'm so excited. Like, I have forgotten what's over there. So anyways, this is, again, for the cookie jar cow, which I may be a fail at, but I don't care. I love them.
And I feel like the key is, it's just inspiring people to start new patterns. So even
yes.
if you don't finish, like, go in the chatter thread and just say, hey.
And it's brought me back to my first love of designers for socks was Cookie A. She's my original, like...
You were a monkey sock fiend.
Fiend. And from the day it came out, I'm pretty sure...
I've been making it for years.
Mm-hmm. And I'm also craving, like, for this one, I may do a monkey sock. Because for me, a monkey sock is a vanilla sock because
mm-hmm.
I've made so many
mm-hmm.
and I totally know the pattern. I don't even look.
Mm-hmm.
Even to start, I think I know it.
Do you do with the pearl or not with the pearl?
I do with the pearl. I like the pearl.
I don't even know what it means, but I know that there are two versions.
There are. And I like the pearl one better.
Cool.
So I wish I knew the name of this. If I... the pattern's over there.
I'll write it down. And I'll make sure I put it on the screen.
And there's two choices on the pattern of design. Like one, it does this really cool thing.
Hmm.
We'll you'll see it. If you really like it, you can look it up. And I'm doing one sock one way and the other. So they're not going to be matching.
Oh,
I'm so excited about it. They're not going to be matching. I mean, they're going to be the same style and the same pattern, but how it ends is going to be different.
That's super neat.
I
like
that. That's all I did this week. I did a ton.
That's all you did. You did so much.
I don't know how because I was super busy.
Well, and it's also been, a week and a half since we last podcasted. Like,
you're right.
It's been definitely over a week. So
it's
we've had
a few
extra days to.
Yes. And again, Mindspace.
Mindspace. No, absolutely.
You can't move back in. I'm sorry.
No, I don't plan on it. God. I mean, I'm going to be 30 this year.
I know. You're going to be 30 this year. You look like you're 18. Turn it on. You are like me. I got carded until I was 35.
God, I get
then it went downhill.
Everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
35, so I have until 35.
You've got a long time.
Okay. Mm-hmm. That makes me feel really good.
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
Perfect.
You guys, what else do you have?
I mean, I have my blanket, but again, I don't know that we need to show my blanket.
Is that cute?
I started a vanilla sock, but I think I'm going to...
What yarn?
Frog it. I don't think I have the tag with me.
What kind?
It's faint. I mean, it's this.
Why are you going to frog it?
Because.
What is that yarn?
I got this at Must Love Yarn, and I don't have the tag with me, so I don't remember.
Sparkle.
Yeah, and it's like the most beautiful, subtle sparkle. Mm-hmm. Gold.
Is it gold? So why do you want to frog it?
Because I think I want to cast on one of Mina's new patterns.
Oh, I agree with you.
And I was like knitting this vanilla sock, and I never got into the rhythm of it for some reason. I'm like, the garter goodness.
You.
Yeah. So I was like, you know what? Mina was lovely. So Mina Phillips of the Knitting Expat podcast, who needs no introduction. Everybody knows who she is and loves her.
Did you see her new Cozy Memories blanket out of triangles?
I must have because
You're
it's ringing
die.
A bell. But
I only saw the picture.
It.
I haven't watched the podcast yet.
Unbelievable.
It's going to kill me not to start one.
You will.
No, I won't. I can't. I have two going.
That's true.
Okay, I will. I don't care. Sorry.
So she was so nice and gifted us both the series of patterns of her new sock patterns.
Yeah. They're like
which
beyond
I
believe, the
beyond
vanilla sock or
yeah.
something like that.
And she also gave us a set to gift to you guys,
which
was so generous of her. And, so wait, let's keep going with that.
Okay.
So I'm going to frog this.
I agree with you. 100%.
Uh-huh.
Do it.
I'm going to cast on one of her Beyond Vanilla patterns.
Let's do that today.
Let's do it. We have all day.
We have damn air. Oh, I'm so bad lately.
I'll find the beep.
Beep. We'll beep that. We have errands.
Yeah, we have errands.
And a pedicure. Because I don't go for pedicures by myself. A, I hate pedicures because I'm super sensitive, my feet.
Mm. She sits there and
it's terrible.
Or she goes,
I like, it's terrible.
It's more maintenance than it is. I mean, we get like, what, two a year? Something like that.
I get like 2 to 3 a summer. Yeah, it's, and I need it because it's fun and I want to get back to wearing flip-flops.
Yeah.
I don't know why we're talking about this, but I don't go alone. So I said to Chels, let's get an appointment. So we have one of the, we have a busy day.
We have a busy fun day.
We have a fun day. Yarn shop.
And then I get to see Julie later. I'm going to hang out with
Julie.
Later.
I want to see Julie.
Maybe she'll come over.
Yeah.
So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to frog that sock because I can't get into it. And I'm so excited about Mina's pattern. So we are going, and we also have another pattern that Julia, which I should have mentioned when I was showing my Squish Delicious shawl.
We're the worsted, sorry.
We're the worsted. Jenny. And so
tree climbing competition is today.
I can't even start. If I start talking about Jenny's podcast, we'll go on for another hour.
I think it's today.
I love
so
it.
Excited. I hope she posts pictures.
I want to climb a mountain with her so badly. I wanted to be there.
I know you guys would be the best. Of
we
friends.
Really, I feel like we would be such good friends.
Mm-hmm. And I would just
which
say
we are already, but like, I feel like we would be like real life.
Yeah. Cause she's so like,
she's an adventurer.
She is. And you guys are too.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, go ahead.
So, Squishalicious shawl.
It
did get hot in here.
Yeah, what's that about?
I don't know.
The pool's not green anymore.
It's blue. It's cloudy blue.
Cloudy blue, but blue. Sorry, go ahead. Squishalicious shawl.
Julia was amazing and gave us a pattern to give away to you, our viewers, as well.
We need to give that away because the cow...
I know, the cow
is now.
The cow is now.
Sorry, that was irresponsible of us.
So I will try and get this uploaded, ASAP so that you guys will have the chance to enter. And we might even, I'm thinking we'll pull it not even on air. I feel like we might do it on Instagram.
Let's wait till we have at least 25.
Definitely.
And then we will pull, and then we will send you a notice and have it sent to you. Yeah, because the knit along is now. I agree. Mm-hmm. So as soon as we get this up and you see this, go enter. Okay, what is the... They're almost gone. This was brimming. Sorry. Okay, what are we going to have them tell us for the Squishalicious?
Okay. So for the Squishalicious, here, I'll pick one and you pick one.
Okay.
So we'll start a thread, and I want you to answer for your Squishalicious shawl. What is your favorite word in the English language?
That is genius.
Because you know what?
Squishalicious. Mine is so boring, but it's a good one.
It is a good one. It's going to be a good resource for people. So, okay. So,
and so for Mina's, which I think we will announce the next podcast.
We'll do that the next podcast because yes. I don't believe she's doing a knit-along.
No, I don't think so either.
If we find out she is, that may change, but we will keep you all
updated. We will do it. We'll give you enough time because I need... It is summer. The pool is almost clean. Mm-hmm. I love to read.
Summer reading.
I need a summer reading list. Okay. So please.
Give us a list.
Give me some names. Mm-hmm. And you know what? If it's an older book that you really enjoyed, but maybe wasn't kind of like off the beaten path.
For sure. Yeah, anything. It doesn't have to be anything new.
No, it can be anything. Mm-hmm. Your favorite book. Like my favorite book, and I don't even remember what it's, I mean, I vaguely remember what it's about. So it's not like it's my favorite book and I memorize lines because I don't have a memory. Is The Confederacy of Dunces.
Ooh.
I don't even know who the author is. I've read it 3 times. I brought it to my book club. I was so excited.
Nope. They didn't want to read it.
No, they read it.
They did not like it.
It was a rough night.
Did you end up sneaking out the back door?
I almost had to. I was like, really? Oh, you didn't love it? Man. Like, I've been in this book club for...
Ever.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
I want to say almost 20 years because we weren't in this house. Almost 20 years. So we are very open and honest, and we let it be known when we don't like something.
Yeah.
So that's one of my favorite books. I couldn't tell you what it's about.
Do you want to know what one of mine is?
What is it?
You introduced it to me last summer. What's the one where they're at the summer house? And...
Oh, that's such a common one.
It is. So it's pretty well known.
It's a young adult. And don't hesitate to write down young adult, because that's my favorite genre. What is that called?
I can't remember. I'll post it on the screen because it is so good. I read it twice in a row.
You have to read it twice.
Yep.
Honestly, I read it twice.
It's, oh,
I'm
so
trying
good.
To think if any of my book clubs have read it. That's one I would bring to a book club as far, because there's so much. I base it on conversation, how much conversation can come
with
it. Oh,
there's so much.
I could read that again right now.
Me too.
Darn it, I wish I remembered the name. Is
I'll
your phone here?
It.
Is it on your Kindle? No,
it's not
you
on
bought
my Kindle.
It.
I bought the.
Anyways, so write down a good summer read or your favorite book or something book related. Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
And then
so that will be for Mina's, and we will open threads today.
Yep.
When you see this,
we have a very long to do list today.
Yeah, long. We're going to forget every last one of the things. We'll do that right when we finish.
Yes.
Okay. So enter, you guys, because both of those patterns. Everyone's all about Mina's right now.
Yeah.
Everyone. And
oh,
it's
so cool.
Exciting because it's that jump from vanilla sock to just a little something to add interest.
Mm-hmm.
And then the Squishalicious.
Oh.
Just for that textured stitch alone.
I can't wait to see people's response to it, like to knitting it, because...
It's a fantastic knit.
You're knitting it and you're like, how is it creating this squishy fat? Like,
oh, it's like brioche without doing brioche.
It's like, we use magical a lot, but it's like magic.
It hit me again this week that I don't know how to do brioche.
You know how to do brioche.
I don't have a clue. I made that whole thing. Anyways, we got to go. Super long.
This is a super long podcast.
Busy.
It's been a couple of weeks. We had a lot to update you on.
And we're going to cut out a lot at the beginning of the.
Oh, definitely. Yeah. So it won't be 2 hours.
Yeah.
But, I'm stepping on my yarn. So I started adding.
We'll be back. Oh. Oh my gosh.
It's kind of pretty.
Oh my God. You are so funny. You just go, I think I'll add this.
Maybe not.
Yeah. Next time you see me, I might be in Vermont.
You just never know with
us. Who knows? We'll see.
So yeah, that's all we have for you guys. Thank you to everybody for tuning in and spending some time with us. We know your options are endless when it comes to podcasts.
Endless, because I keep finding new ones that I'm so enjoying. Next week, I'll talk about a couple of new ones that I watched.
Ooh, cool. Okay.
I can't remember. I have to really look. I watched so many that I forget names.
Oh, yeah, that's
Yarn 30 was one of them. Ooh. I know that. She's on my, she's Cat's Kettle Yarn. Uh-huh. She's on my Periscope. Katrina, she's lovely.
Oh.
I only watched her recent one because I wanted to kind of catch up with her because she's always on my Periscope, and it was super fun to watch.
Oh, cool.
Great yarn dyer, too. Okay, we gotta go. Yeah,
your options are endless. Thank you.
Do you know we forgot Needles Up last time?
I know, and I didn't even catch it when we were editing.
I didn't either.
And somebody said that was like the only reason I knew you guys were off because there was Needles Up.
Yeah, no Needles Up.
So.
Not even my knitting, but.
Whatever. Knit their needles. Have a great week. We'll be seeing you again next week around this time, and we love each and every one of you.
Thank you for being here.
Needles up.
Needles up.
Bye-bye.